So I'm just going to do a little example of how we can address the requirements of the performing elective under the music technology heading for the Leaving Cert. I'm going to try and put together three or four parts to form a backing track ourselves that's something akin to U2 New Year's Day. So I've started with some drums here and I've started to program them. I've started with a maraca sound. I've programmed quavers, 8 notes in the editor, and put a bit of emphasis on the second and fourth note. Okay, so now I can copy that along if I want and create a bit of a change at this point. So I might put in a kick here. Have a listen. Okay, I might want to create a bit more emphasis in that kick, so I might just double it up here with the second kick sound. Find a snare sound and put a snare on 2 and 4. So I'm building up my beat now. I might make the editor a bit longer to program a bit more variety over 4 bars, say. So I can I'll just undo that actually. I'm going to duplicate it along. It's an easier way to do it. So now I've got 4 bars that I'm programming over. Perhaps I want to put a crash at the start of the loop. Perhaps I want to do a little bit of rhythmical variation. I can go into the end of the loop here on my snare. I'll just zoom in and perhaps I'll program over 16th notes and put a little snare fill at the end. So if we just listen to that fill at the end. Okay, so that's me creating some rhythmical changes. I might duplicate that along another little bit. So I've programmed some drums already. Now I'm going to go on to doing a bass line. So I'm creating a new clip on the next track down, first to program some MIDI notes for the bass. So we'll be able to hear a preview of the bass instrument on the piano roll on the left. I've chosen a very basic and simple bass for those listening through laptop speakers so that you'll be able to hear it, but a lot better quality sounds are available. So starting to program in and putting in an A note here, I can go down and try another note. I'm going to go with A, C, E for starters, and finding my E and then dragging it out. So I've got semi-breve over a full bar here, and then a third note over 2 bars. Okay, so perhaps I want to try some rhythmical variation here. So I'm going to change the resolution of my editor to quavers or 8th notes. Put a few quavers in at the start here, the longer notes. I'm going to do the same on the second note in the phrase. Have a little listen. Okay, we might make it a little bit different for this third note. So a couple of quavers, then a crotchet, and another 3 quavers. So duplicate that long. Okay, so currently the notes I've chosen are in the scale of C major. If I want to change the scale, I'm going to move all the notes down a semitone and have a quick look at those. So I've got a G sharp, I've got a B, and I've got a D sharp notes, which do feature in the scale of B major. So I'm going to use those. I also know there's a little bit of variety, so no, we need to put it onto B note in the scale. Yeah, okay, so I'm going to make that little bit of variety change, and I know we need to do a similar chain in the third note. We'll try a lower note to make it a bit more interesting before coming into the last bar. So let's have a listen. Okay, so I'm happy with that. So I'm going to copy this down another 8 bars. And I could extend this to 32 bars if that's the requirement, but just for the example, we'll just work over these 8 bars now. Okay, so let's go and make a piano part. So to save a bit of time, I have a bit of a piano clip set up where I've drawn in three notes. So if we listen to this, I'm just going to solo it. Effectively, I've drawn in what the left hand might be playing. So perhaps a student isn't as proficient on the piano, and we can set it up so you just have to record one hand melody line. So I can now go on to a fourth track to make another part, and I've a piano set up. So I'll take the solo off here. Piano hooked up, MIDI piano, where we can record. So I can go in and record a played part over the bits we've programmed. There you go, not perfect, but you can see we've recorded our parts live over the top. You could go in and edit those or quantize them, but we probably want to record natural performance. So that's just a little example, okay?